Hello students, so in today's class, the second part of human digestive system we are going to start. So human digestive system starts from the buccal cavity, which in our normal day-to-day language we name it as mouth. This buccal cavity will be comprising of many subparts. It will be comprising of teeth, okay, we'll discuss about it. It will be comprising of the tongue. It will be comprising of the lateral cheek and the transverse lips. So buccal cavity will also have salivary glands, which are 3 in number. Okay. Now, after this buccal cavity, you can see the buccal cavity as well as the nasal passage is having a common path over here. So very closely to the food pipe, the windpipe also is present, and that is why over the windpipe always there is a small flap like structure or epiglottis, whose function we are going to understand in the respiration topic. So coming back to the human digestive system, the alimentary canal continues with this long tube like structure, which is known as esophagus. Now, important to understand is that this esophagus does not contain any digestive gland. So, no digestion will be taking place when the food reaches in the esophagus. Still, it is very important as it is a passage to reach towards the stomach. Now, after the esophagus, a J-shaped organ will arise. You can see this J-shaped organ. This is known as the stomach. Whenever the food reaches the stomach, three main important things happen. First of all, the stomach will expand. When it expands, the food completely can enter into this J-shaped organ. Second thing, there could be mechanical churning of the food particle. Third, the digestion will start. For the digestion, the stomach majorly contains gastric glands. Along with the gastric glands, there are many other cells which pour their own secretion. So the stomach will have certain secretion, like it will have HCl, it will have mucus, and it will have protein digesting enzyme, whose name and function we are going to detail in understanding in some time. So that means protein digestion begins in the stomach only, because before that, none of the part has protein digesting enzymes over here. Now, can you see the stomach continues and enters into a small part? Can you see that? This part? This part is basically the small intestine that just starts below the stomach part and remains very coiled. Can you see the smaller, thinner portion? This is the small intestine. So small intestine as compared to the large intestine is smaller, but is smaller in its diameter, but it is very, very long, and that is why it is highly coiled, and that is coiling helps it to be fit in this compact space. So small intestine, the prior part where it is having the stomach also connected, is known as duodenum. We'll talk about duodenum. Duodenum is the part which is connected with liver and also connected with the pancreas. This means the food never enters into the liver or the pancreas, but rather the secretion of the liver, that is the bile juice, is poured into this duodenum. As well as pancreas also secrete its digestive enzymes, which again is poured into this duodenum part. The food will be already present in the duodenum part, and digestion can take place in the small intestine. Small intestine itself is also a digestive place. Digestive gland is also present over here. So further digestion will take place in this small intestine part. Small intestine, after digestion, also helps in absorption. This happens because small intestine has certain finger-like projection. Can you see this finger-like projection? Now, these finger-like projections are known as villi. These finger-like projection helps in increasing the surface of area of the small intestine. For example, the small intestine is a finger-like projection. It could be having only this much surface area for absorption. Now it can absorb from all this part. So absorption rate will increase. So villi can also be present, and sometime the villi itself has certain more finger-like projection to increase even the surface area even more. And these can be known as microvilli. This will be known as what? Microvilli. Are you understanding this thing? Now, after the small intestine has absorbed all the important food components from here, the rest of the food that is not to be absorbed reaches the large intestine. Now, this large intestine, you can see three sections. One, from here the food has to rise up. This part is known as ascending colon. The left to right part of the large intestine, can you see this part? Is known as transverse colon. And the top to down portion is known as descending colon. Can you name why it is known as ascending? Yes, because food is ascending. Food upar ki taraf chad raha hai, to use ascending colon bola gaya. Yahan pe isko transverse colon aur yahan isko descending colon. That means on the basis of the food movement, it is being decided. In the ascending colon only, this portion is known as appendix. It is a vestigial part of the body. Many of you must have heard about the appendicitis problem. When this appendix is removed by surgery, it is removed and the person is able to live because it's a vestigial organ. We will talk about vestigial organ in our later on classes. Now, after this large intestine, we have the rectum present over here, which is the storage organ. Can you see the storage organ? And from here, the excretory, the ingested food has to come out of the body through the anus. Have you understood this thing? Now, the diaphragm is made over here only to explain you that the diaphragm is going to separate the thoracic cavity containing the lungs and the heart from the abdominal cavity. So all this stomach, liver, everything is there in the abdominal cavity over here. Now, can you see a gallbladder word written over here? The gallbladder is an organ which is again present inside the liver. So whatever bile juice is produced by this liver does not come into the duodenum part directly, but it is stored in the gallbladder from some time, and time to time it is secreted into the duodenum part of the small intestine. Have you understood till here? Okay, to explain it in more detail, let us talk about the various parts of it. The buccal cavity, as I have discussed, it consists of the mouth, which is having a transverse opening, or the lips. Teeth. Presence of teeth in human beings have been explained by the names of diphyodont. Diphyodont matlab two types. We are having milk teeth as well as permanent teeth. Two types of teeth. Can you see that? Heterodont. Heterodont means we are having four kinds of functional teeth present. We have incisor, canine, premolar and molar. This is the dental formula of an adult human being. This incisor, canine, premolar, molar. So 1/4 of the mouth, 2, 1, 2, 3. Again 2, 1, 2, 3. If we again add the left hand half of the jaw again, this totality will make 32 teeth of an adult human being. Have you understood? Tongue. Tongue is a protrusible. Protrusible matlab retractable. It helps in chewing also, and it helps in mixing of the food, mastication. This helps as a taste receptor. It helps in mixing saliva with food. It helps also in speech. Salivary gland over here produces saliva. Saliva will have salivary amylase as the enzyme, and it will also have some mucus. Here the mucus is making basically the mouth to water whenever we see a tasty food or we smell a tasty food. Basically it is wetting the food to make the passage through the alimentary canal smooth, whose lining is very soft. Otherwise, by friction of the food particle, there could be membrane disruption of the alimentary canal. So this salivary amylase, remember this word amylase, if there is there in the enzyme word, it will always mean that it will digest any kind of carbohydrate. Salivary amylase is also known as ptyalin. What it is known as? Ptyalin. It works only and only in alkaline medium, that means basic medium. And whenever the food reaches this buccal cavity, it will convert starch into maltose, which is a comparatively simpler food. Have you understood this thing? So we will talk about the next part in our next video.